Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Appreciate your holding this hearing. Prevention, a simple idea with a profound implication for the future of Western forests and communities. Right now, fires are burning thousands of acres in Colorado, Arizona, and in many areas throughout the Western United States. The incident commander is in charge of suppression on a 110,000-acre fire in the West Fork, burning in my district, which has threatened entire communities, told me that the behavior of the fire is unprecedented. Because of all the beetle-killed timber and dry conditions, the fire has acted in a way that defies computer models and has been incredibly devastating. The environmental effect of this fire will continue to impact our communities for years after the fire is out. The most tragic part of this is that the occurrence of these forest fires could be reduced, if not outright prevented, with common sense forest management. By taking actions such as removing hazardous fuels like beetle-killed timber and unnaturally dense undergrowth, we would not only be able to allow our forests to thrive in healthy natural states, but to be able to prevent future loss of life and destruction of property, safeguard water supplies, species habitat, air quality, and promote a healthy natural environment overall. The President spends a fair amount of his time speaking about the need to be able to reduce carbon emissions, and just the other week announced his latest fiat to be able to move forward with a significant backdoor energy tax that will work further restrict responsible energy development in this country and stunt job growth. If the President is truly interested in reducing carbon emissions without handcuffing our nation's economy, his administration should take meaningful action to prevent catastrophic wildfires that are burning in California, Arizona, and other parts of the West. According to a 2012 presentation from NASA, carbon dioxide emissions from wildfires have more than doubled, up 2.4 times since the 1980s. The amount of carbon emissions from wildfires has grown from an average of 8.8 million tons per year from 1984 to 1985 to more than 22 million tons from 1996 to 2008. Wildfire can often emit more carbon in a few weeks than all of the cars in that state do in a year. This was the case in the Hayman Fire in Colorado and likely will be the case with West Fork Complex Fire. In addition, according to a 2007 study published by NIH, wildfires can be primary contributors to individual states' total carbon emissions. In Idaho in 2006, wildfire produced 1.6 times more CO2 than all other fossil fuel sources. In 2006, wildfire emissions also accounted for 47% and 42% of CO2 emissions in Montana and Washington, respectively. And according to a report from researchers with the Forest Service, Auburn University, and George Mason University, wildfire CO2 emissions are expected to increase by 50% by the year 2050. When trees are growing, they absorb carbon, but when the trees die, like thousands of acres of dead bark beetle trees that cover our hillsides, it starts to release carbon slowly as it decomposes, or rapidly when it burns. The failure to address responsible forest management for the health of natural environment and for the safety of our communities simply defies logic. If we proactively manage our forests, we can remove dead trees and restore forest areas with healthy trees that will once again absorb carbon, restore our environment to a healthy state, and protect people and communities from catastrophic wildfire. When developing a plan to improve conditions throughout the Western United States, vast expanses of forests, it should be common sense to include the input of those who live in the region and have a boots-on-the-ground view of the urgent challenges facing forest management. To that end, I proposed a comprehensive, all-hands-on-deck approach to restoring forest health. The Healthy Forest Management and Wildfire Prevention Act, H.R. 818, would give states and affected counties and tribes the authority to designate high-risk areas on the National Forest System land and lands under the jurisdiction of the Bureau of Land Management, as well as the authority to be able to provide for the development of proposed emergency hazardous fuels reduction projects for these high-risk areas. With increased local control, states can better protect their communities, species habitats, water supplies, and natural areas with preventative action to control conditions fueling devastating wildfires. In addition to the environmental benefits of this legislation, it would provide incredible long-term cost savings by investing in prevention. The cost of proactive, healthy forest management is far less than the cost of wildfire suppression. According to the Forest Service, the agency spent $296 million on hazardous fuel reduction treatments nationwide in 2012, while spending $1.77 billion on wildfire suppression during the same time. That is why this legislation and today's hearing is important and what it's about, getting ahead of this problem by investing in greater resources toward prevention so we can make a more proactive approach to restoring our forest health to a natural state and preventing intense wildfires that have caused so much damage throughout the West. I look forward to today's hearing and the testimony from the committee. Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and I yield back.
Thank you. I appreciate your testimony and your time here.